Hi guys, my name is Harvansh and first of all thanks for watching my the other videos about the semantic tutorial. If you have not watched that videos or you want to learn more into the antivirus, you can go to the my SCCM tutorial. So there I was explained about semantic antivirus, about their features, functionality and how it will work. Okay guys, so today I'm going to start a new tutorial about SCCM. So I will explain in my coming tutorials how the SCCM is working and about the all of features. And it's before this video I have created one more video, how to install SQL database 2016. So if you have not watched that video, please go and watch it if you are planning to build your own lab. So let's start this video. This video is about SCCM installation and I'm going to use 16.06 version. So here is my setup file and open the setup file, double click and the setup will launch. So just want to tell you, already I have installed prerequisite here because prerequisite always is taking more time. And if you want like videos and it's a bit to understand of, so you can let me know. I will create a separate video how we can install the prerequisite, or you can go to the Microsoft TechNet. There is a complete details are there what kind of prerequisites you want. Okay, so my console is open here and here is the option to install. I am going to install my completely SCCM, not only the console. So if you want to install only the console and already your SCCM is running somewhere, you can click here, install configuration manager console. So you will get the only console installation. Okay, so let me click on install. Click on yes. And here is click on next and here is a so many options. So how, what is the meaning of this option? If you select this option, this is for the primary site, but if you are having the cache infrastructure and your cache site is already installed, you can choose this option. And if you want to install a standalone primary site, select this option. So it will be it will be like a standalone primary site. Okay, and if you are planning to install your cache, so select this option. And to be make sure, if you are installing cache server, you should in your info you should be having at least one or more primaries. So I am going to install my the standalone primary. Click on next. It asking do you want to continue. Okay, and here is a for the product key. If you are the, if you are in the your production environment, so obviously you will be having the license key. So enter the license key. And if you are in the evolution version, you can select this. And as I am in the lab infra, so I am selecting the evolution version. Click on next. Accept the all the license terms and I click on next. So here is the option, something like a download required. So it's this is for SCCM updates. I will show you here. If you want to download before it, before running the console, you can click here, get the latest configuration manager update. So already I downloaded that updates. Or if you want to download it during the installation, you should be having the internet access on your machine. So already I downloaded. And let me give the path here. It's an SCCM software and the SCCM update. So give this path, click on next and it will validate whether the all the files are available or not. Okay, so it's validated. Now it's a time to give the site code. Site code is site code always it will be in a 3-digit. It can be the numeric and it can be the alphabetic, or it can be the combination of alpha and numeric. So let me give the BLR site, and here I am giving it's a Bangalore primary site. And my the installation path will be, if I'm not changing, by default it will be taking a C drive, and I don't want to install in a C drive. Let me go with the D drive. Okay, and make sure you should be having there the program file, program files folder. If it is not there, you can create it. Okay, so already I have my program files folder here. When I was installing my SQL database, so I was created this. Just change the D drive, and this option is install the configuration manager console. So if this option should be checked anyway, it by default it will be checked, but just verify it. If this option is not checked, your console will not installed. Okay, so checked it and click on next. Click on next, and here it asking to get the connected. So where it will be the connected? That is the service connection point. So I am in the same server. I have the service connection point on the same server only. Okay, so here is a setup type. It's a simply setup, and the site code BLR. You can validate your all the things whatever you are putting during running the setup, and if there is a something mismatch, you can go back, click on the previously and correct it. If all good, then click on next. Now it will check the prerequisite, whether all the prerequisites are installed or not. If there is any something missing, it will show the error or the warning. So here is something is missing, WSS on the site server. Okay, WSS I have not installed yet, because I will show you in the next video how we can install the WSS and how it will integrate our SCCM. So that's why I have not installed WSS. The second thing is a permission in a AD. So I given the permission, but I'm not sure why it's not sync up with the AD. Okay, but if you are in the production, this prerequisite will be completed. You have to give the permission on your system management folder. So it's a memory allocation. It's like the unlimited. I have not given the unlimited uses for the SQL. If I'm giving, then my the most of the memory will be waste on SQL uses. Okay, so I have not binded it. Second thing is a SQL allocation. SQL allocation, it required minimum 8 GB, and I am on the lab server, and I have a shortage for RAM, so I have not given. Anyway, with these warnings we can continue. If there is any warning, you can continue the setup. If there is any like a critical, then you cannot continue your setup. Okay, so click on begin install. So now our setup will start installing, and we can keep monitoring whether the everything fine going on or not. So guys, it will take some time, and if you want to monitor the logs, you can click here. And this setup usually it will take at least 25 to 30 minutes. Okay, so setup is started. So guys, you can see in it so many options are installed. Actually, I pause this video because it will be like boring, because there is a nothing going on. Okay, so I will continue this. Now is setting up the SQL database. It will take some time, and here we can see the measure of time, how much time it's taking for the installation. Okay guys, so this setting up SQL database is completed, and now copying the files, and we have to wait until all the tasks will be completed. Hi guys, so it's done. My setup is successfully installed. So let's verify whether all the components are installed well or not. So here you can see in all the green. So that means this component installed successfully. There is no error. So now my console is installed, and let me close this. And let me close this also. Click on exit. And now let me launch the console. Okay, so it name will be configuration manager console. Click here, and it will take little bit time because it's a first time console is launching, so it will create its cache, or it will take some time to launch, so we can wait till that. Okay guys, so you can see in it, my console is installed well and there is no issue. Now you can see in the how the console is looks like for 1606. Okay, so these are the options. I will show you and which option, how it's working, what is that meaning in my coming video. So this video was about to how we can install SCCM console. Okay guys, so thanks for watching this video and keep watching the continue. I will be publishing more tutorials about the SCCM. Thanks again. Thank you guys, and please subscribe my channel and press on bell icon so you will be getting the notification for the coming videos. Okay guys, thank you.